As we all know, architecture of RTOS consists of command line, command interpreter graphics interface, POSIX and UNIX graphics programming interface, and graphics support library, a networking block, ANSI compliant C library, and a kernel services block, as well as device drivers block. So today our topic is we'll learn about kernel. What is kernel? Kernel can be defined as the certain module of computer operating system or a system's operating system that manages the communication between the user level application and the hardware. Kernel task includes process management, device management, memory management, interrupt handling, etc. These tasks are done in kernel space in operating system. There are mainly three broad categories of kernel models, namely monolithic kernel, microkernel, and exokernel. What is a monolithic kernel? So it runs all the basic system services such as IPCs, that is inter-process communication, process and memory management, interrupt handling, IO communication, file system, etc. in the kernel space. Earlier in monolithic architecture, all the basic system services were expected into the single module in kernel space. This led to some serious drawbacks such as size of the kernel becomes large and for bug fixing or additional of new features. We want recompile the whole kernel which could consume hours, but in the new approach the kernel is having different modules which can be dynamically loaded and unloaded. Thus maintainability becomes very easy, loading and unloading only the concerned module. A Linux is an example of a monolithic kernel. Microkernel runs on the basic IO control and process communication and other basic system services such as file system, network, etc. will run on the user space. So in this architecture, the kernel space will be with minimal and user space will be large. This architecture is more stable than monolithic. Amiga OS and QNX are the examples of microkernel. Exokernel is an operating system that provides application level management of physical resources. Exokernel is extremely small and provides efficient control over the hardware. RTOS generally avoids using monolithic architecture since it uses large kernel space. The RTOS is developed by microkernel with adding configurable functionalities since it uses less kernel space. RTOS kernel provides an abstraction layer between the hardware and application software. The kernel provides six services, namely task management, interrupt and event handling, memory management, device IO management, as well as timer management, task synchronization, and inter-task communication. We'll look into this in next session. I hope we got an overview about the kernel.